A lot of people are talking about how agents get created out of foundation models. We're lucky to have a more natural approach from the pioneer herself. Stay tuned for this episode of Cozy AI Kitchen. So I was at a place called the MIT Media Lab for a good part of my life, and there I had the chance to work with Professor Pattie Maes. She was my senior, I was her junior. I always admired what she did, either in industry or in academia. And we're so glad to have Pattie here at the Cozy AI Kitchen. She is the pioneer of the agents revolution. Pattie, welcome to the kitchen.
Hey, thank you, John. Thank you for having me, and good to see you again.
Is it okay in the fridge? It gets a bit cold in there, or?
A bit cold, but I'm used to that in Boston.
New England. So, Pattie, you've been noticing all this agent stuff. You, as someone who literally called out agents in the 90s as a different way to write software, what are your thoughts right now?
Yeah, I have mixed feelings about what is happening right now, actually. On the one hand, it's super exciting that AI is really getting somewhere right now. But I do believe that AI researchers are a little bit misguided by this goal of trying to reach AGI and basically create AI that surpasses us. And I've always been advocating that instead we should develop AI that augments people, that helps people with, making smarter decisions, basically. So I feel like the goal is a little bit misguided, and that we will learn the hard way when we introduce these systems in a human context, that things aren't all about engineering these systems, but that there are a lot of human design problems and issues that have to be resolved for AI to ultimately benefit people and society.
Why do you think that this human element gets forgotten so often?
Yeah, I think, people basically aren't very rational. And for example, if you have an AI that gives you suggestions or recommendations for how to think about something, what decision to make in a particular context, what we have shown with our work is that people become over-reliant on these systems. They start getting a little bit lazy, especially when an AI system comes up with beautiful explanations, which is what these chatbots today, of course, are doing. They sound incredibly believable, but they are not always right. And in our studies that we have done with hundreds and hundreds of subjects, we show that people are over-reliant and stop thinking for themselves if you just give them an agent that makes the answer to a problem readily available. So it's important that we think about how we design the interface to these systems. For example, what we showed is that an agent that first engages you by asking you some questions about the problem domain, the problem you're trying to solve, if you have that interaction initially with an agent before it gives you its expertise, its suggestion, then people actually start thinking about the problem and they don't necessarily blindly follow whatever the agent tells them is the right answer. So we've done lots of studies like that show that basically the human context matters a lot, and that we have to think a lot more carefully about how we design the interaction between people and AI.
Well, that's so, I mean, you're making me remember why I liked working with you all at the Media Lab, because that human and technology components, they were always intertwined. I have in the last year taken the semantic kernel toaster and foundation models and built AI from scratch with these models, have jumped on the agent's bandwagon with personas you were mentioning, and personas are convenient ways to define the kind of personality of the AI. I have now a space-age microwave oven to represent agents. But to your point, Should we believe what they say? Should we be humans that think about them differently? Let's do some cooking, Pattie. Okay. All right. Okay, so this is the special recipe we've made for you, Pattie. It is the AI Agents Pioneer and Fluid Interfaces Expert recipe. And I want to note for everyone who is new to agents, agents are not new. Pattie was the vanguard of agents in the 90s, talking about this paradigm well before anyone else in computer science. Okay, so Pattie, what we're going to do is bring over some packages. Ooh, look out, restart, restart. You know, this is my code, so it's not perfect. Okay, restart kernel. Okay, and this is the moment. There we go. Okay, clear outputs. Okay. Okay, we're going to bring over. No, this is the wrong part. 1 second. Restart kernel. As you can see, Pattie, in the kitchen, it gets a little messy here for a second. 1 second. Okay, there we go.
AI is imperfect and people aren't perfect.
Ah, beautiful. Perfect for the kitchen. Okay, packages came over. Made a semantic kernel, bringing over the experimental agents package. And what I'm doing next is I've made a bunch of agents in the kitchen, Pattie, and there are some that involve teaching, writing, a restaurant scenario, but I also have Media Lab agents as well. I have three agents. One is a Media Lab gateway. This is the person that greets corporate sponsors. I know you have a lot of corporate sponsors, Pattie, at the Media Lab. And the navigator takes them around the lab. Pardon me, Pattie?
I could use a couple of extra students as well if you're at it.
I've added a Media Lab fluid interfaces researcher. That's a good one, Pattie. Okay, and then we're going to, I've now brought them over. This is code that takes that persona definition, binds it to a non-gendered name. Randomly, and then I'm going to take these personas, and I now have them, Alex, Jordan, and Taylor. Okay, and I'm now going to ask this group of agents, a sponsor has arrived at the MIT Media Lab, who among these should be the first one to greet them? And so there is a agentic debate of who is the right one to greet them. Will it be the one of your students? Probably not. It is Alex. It is the gateway for today's visit. Alex is all ready to go. And furthermore, Alex, now we know Alex has defined themselves as the one to talk with. We're going to pretend a sponsor arrived at the Media Lab. Do your thing. Okay, and they're very interested in learning more about the Media Lab. Can you talk a little bit about the history of the Media Lab, Pattie, for those who that's a new thing?
Yeah, so the Media Lab is almost 40 years old. And wow. What makes it unique is that it's very interdisciplinary. We have artists, we have designers, we have engineers, we have scientists, and all of these people with very different backgrounds come together to think about how cutting-edge technologies may sort of enable people and empower them. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I remember. Yes, exactly. A place where art and science and technology all coexist. Okay. Now I'm going to be a demanding corporate sponsor. Sometimes it happens. Thanks. I want to see the work of Pattie Maes. I hear she's a genius. So now I'm like sort of bugging the gateway and like, okay, good. I got your overview. And now it's going to go and help me understand what's next. And I had it doing speech, et cetera, but for this to go faster, and because you're so deep, there's so much stuff. There's Pattie. This is who she is. Hopefully it is correct. Sixth Sense sounds correct. Okay.
Looks correct from my level, yeah.
Looks right, isn't it? Looks right, okay. And then, and of course, we could bring in new embeddings to sort of improve it, to make it more new. And then I ask it, which agent should be used next in this lab visitor scenario? Because now the gateway helped me out, and now the question is who's next? And then it eventually surfaces the navigator to give me a tour of the lab. But this stuff is, when you mentioned before this call, Pattie, it makes you think things. Can you elaborate on that? if this is what people think agents should do, is this the direction that you were hoping agents would become?
Well, I think we have to think a little bit more about, again, the interaction between people and agents. Ultimately, AI gets used in a human context, and we have to think about sort of not just what agents can do for us and how they can automate stuff on our behalf, but then how do we make sure that we understand how they operate, what their limitations are, whether they may make mistakes or whether some areas you better not ask them to help you with because they don't have that expertise. So yeah, I think we have to think about all of that. How do we stay in control of those agents? What if they're telling stuff about my work that isn't true? So yeah, how do we remain sort of informed about them, remain in control? Ultimately, I would always argue people should be the ones that are in charge and are the ones that benefit, and we shouldn't have this unruly set of agents that we barely understand and that may create a lot of havoc as well as helping us with some of our tasks.
And maybe can you give some closing thoughts on 90s, this is what agents were to you, and now in the 2020s, what is it to you now?
Yeah, well, obviously in the 90s, we didn't have large language models or anything, so we had to construct these systems by hand. The benefit was that we did understand them a lot better and could predict sort of where they would fall apart or not. Of course, today's AI is more a little bit of a black box. The people who train these models don't want to tell them what they're trained on or how they may have fine-tuned them and so on. And so we have to approach them carefully, but they're, of course, so much more powerful, and there's a lot of amazing opportunities and amazing ways in which they will and already do enhance all of our work. Like I don't just want a couple of agents doing research. I also even more so want a couple of fundraising agents. So please create me some of those so I spend less time on that.
Well, the Media Lab is looking for sponsors all the time, and the students are, it's a great place to go to. Thank you so much, Pattie, for joining us in the Cozy AI Kitchen.
So great to be here. Yes, thank you. Thank you for the invitation.
All right. Well, let's keep on cooking in the kitchen, and let's see what's in the future.